Hello, good morning children. Welcome back to the new session. Today let us start the grammar part. Firstly, it is tenses. Tense is one of the most important topics in English grammar. It is very essential to learn accurate English, to learn perfect English. Let us start. Tense is a grammatical term. It is a word which is used in grammar. It means it refers the time of the action. It shows when the action is taken place or when the action will be taken place, right? It refers the time of the action. Basically, there are three tenses. First one is present, second one past, and thirdly future. Present, past, and future. Again, there are four categories in each, right? Firstly, present tense, it has four: simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. In past tense also, there are four subdivisions: simple past, past continuous, past perfect continuous. In future also, there are four subdivisions: simple future, future continuous, future perfect continuous. Totally, there are 12 tenses. Let us study in detail one by one. Firstly, simple present tense. Simple present tense is in the form of SVO pattern: subject, verb, object. In simple present tense, V1 form is used. Verbs are written in four forms: V1, V2, V3, and V4. Basic form, past participle form, and present participle form. V4 is ing form, right? In present tense, what we use? We use V1 form, the root verb. Before starting that structure of the sentence, let us know the personal pronouns. There are 7 basic pronouns in English grammar. They are I, we, you, he, she, and it. You can be used singular as well as plural. And we can classify them in 3 categories: first person, second person, and third person. First person means the speaker who expresses ideas and thoughts. He is speaker. And second person means receiver of those ideas or thoughts. One who listens is listener. He is called second person. And what they discuss, that is third person. For example, I am speaking, I am first person. You are listening, you are receiving the thoughts or content, that is second person. You are second person, and the grammar is third person here. What we are discussing, that is third person. We can divide the basic pronouns singular and plural. I is first person singular, and its plural form is we. You can be used singular as well as plural. And third person singular pronouns are 3. They are he, she, and it. They is third person plural form. I hope you have studied this in the previous classes. It is just to remind you. Here we have the structure of the sentence. This flowchart will help you to understand. The pronouns are the names of person, place, things, can be written in as subject. They are subject. I, we, you, they. These are first person and second person. And he, she, it, they are third person singular. Helping verb, there are 2. One is do and one more is does. Do is used for first person and second person, and does is used for third person singular form. And here what we use, already I suggested you, V1 form is used. Verb used in base or V1 form. And usage of this tense. It denotes all the habitual actions and the action that takes place immediately. This tense, this format is used to refer the habitual actions. Habitual actions means the actions which take place regularly. The sun rises in the east. That action takes place every day. That is called habitual actions. The cow gives milk. Then my father works in army. We can say I read storybooks. These are the regular activities that they can be expressed in simple present tense. We can classify the simple present tense sentences into three categories: affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Let us know the structure of them. Affirmative sentences means the positive statements. Negative sentences are the sentences which have the negative words like no, not, none, never, and so on. They will be having the negative word, so they are called negative sentences. Affirmative means positive. Let us know the difference between them, how they are written. In affirmative sentences, subject plus helping verb plus main verb. For example, here I is subject, I'll read them. I, we, you, they, he, she, it. These are pronouns. They can be used as subject. And helping verbs, there are two: do and does. And main verb, anyone can be used: go, went, sleep, eat, speak, run, jump, so on. Anyone can be used. One thing we must remember in simple present tense while writing affirmative sentence: the helping verb is written in the form of understood manner. It is not written directly. It is present in the sentence that in the manner of understood. I will read, for example, I is subject and do is auxiliary verb, but I don't write or read while expressing. But it is present in the simple present tense. I speak English. The helping verb is do, but it is not pronounced, right? I speak English, we speak English, you speak English, they speak English. In the same manner, does also. One thing we must remember here: while using third person singular in simple present tense, we have to add yes, es, or is at the end of the root word. For example, here root verb is speak. We should not use the same which we used already for I, we, you, they. That is different. They are first person, second person, and third person plural. But while using third person singular, he, she, it, we should use yes, or es, or is at the end of the verb. He speaks English. It is not speak, speaks. She speaks English. It speaks English. Right? In the same manner, the rule will be applicable for other verbs also. Negative sentences: the pronouns are same, the subject are same. I, we, you, they, he, she, it. What we change here is the helping verb and the negative word is used. Not, do not, and does not. Main verb is the same. Speak English. I do not speak English. We do not speak English. You do not speak English. They do not speak English. He doesn't speak English. She doesn't speak English. It doesn't speak English. While writing negative word, the presence of auxiliary verb, helping verb, will be appeared, right? While writing affirmative sentence, it is written in the manner of understood. Do not and does not, they are full form. they can be written in contraction form, that is, don't, do not can be written in the manner, in the form, don't, and does not can be written, doesn't. Right? Next one, here it is, the negative contraction. The negative statements will be having the short form of do not and does not. Do not is written don't and does not is written doesn't in this manner. Simple present tense keywords. Here we have some adverbs which can be used in simple present tense that they help us to identify in which tense it is. Every, daily, mostly, generally, usually, casually, normally, regularly, always, often, rarely, sometimes, seldom, hardly, on Sunday, ever, never, first, and then, so on. The list goes. These are the adverbs which can be used in simple present tense. Lastly, how to use it? It is used to express the usage of simple present tense. First one is, it is used to express habitual actions. All habitual actions are expressed through simple present tense. The rainbow has 7 colors, right? The fish lives in water. The habitual action. An action that always happens. That action in the same manner. Habitual action that always happens. Future planned actions. The actions which are planned to be done in the future. I will buy a new car. It is future action. I buy a car. That can be written in simple present tense. Proverbs. The thoughtful sentences. A stitch in time saves 9. Here saves is present form, right? It is always written in the present form. Proverbs, sayings. One more can be written. One more can be given as example. Time and tide wait for none. It is not waited or waiting or has been waiting, right? Wait for none. It is V1 form. Time and tide wait for none. These are proverbs. Sayings of a great person. Quotes. Swaraj is my birthright. I shall have it. Is present form, right? Sayings are written in the form of present tense. Quotations. Historical events. The construction of monuments. Historical monuments that they are expressed in the simple present tense. Universal truth. Universal truth means that for all the long period of time it remains the same. The sun shines brightly. It is always universal truth it is. This is the usage of simple present tense. In the next session, let us list out some examples for simple present tense and let us recall what we studied already. Let us use a passage to learn or to identify the simple present tense sentences. Thank you. Have a nice day.